Hi cadets, good morning. In the last two video classes, I completed exercise question for chapter number 1, that is power sharing. Today and tomorrow, we'll try to complete the exercise for chapter number 2, that is federalism. Cadets, please take your notebooks as well as pen. Please start writing the exercise question. This is NCERT based question and answers. Once you are back to the school, then definitely we will try to answer more questions based on the old or previous year's question papers, because that exercise we can do maybe after the month of January, February, so that you can very well face examination in the month of March 2021. Let us move to the topic. Exercise part, I told you this is exercise based on just given in a NCERT book. Question number 1. In this question, you are expected to do an outline map of India. Locate the following states in a blank outline map of India. So please draw an outline map of India. After drawing an outline map of India, you are supposed to locate Manipur, Sikkim, Chhattisgarh and Goa. So in the outline map of India, you are supposed to locate Manipur, Sikkim, Goa and Chhattisgarh. These are the states you have to locate. So I hope you are able to locate Goa, Manipur, Sikkim and Chhattisgarh in this map which is given in your textbook. This map, political map of 2006. So please draw a outline map of India, and in that outline map of India, following the states, please locate the states. It will take time, so please do it. Let us move to the second question. Second question expects from you that identify and shade 3 federal countries other than India on a blank outline political map of the world. So what you have to do, you have to trace or get an outline map of world, that is world political map. The world political map, it is given in your textbook, of course. In that, you have to locate the countries which have federal form of government, and while locating federal form of government, you have to locate and shade those countries other than India. This map is given in a textbook. You can see the shaded countries are the federal countries, federal political republic system. Australia is there, Russia is there, Germany, Belgium, Switzerland, Spain, Austria, Nigeria, Ethiopia, South Africa, Brazil, Argentina, United States of America, Canada, and many more states are mentioned in your, or labeled in your textbook. So please label any 3 states. For example, I am labeling Australia. You label Australia or South Africa and Nigeria. Okay, 3 states other than India which follow the federal form of government. So please do this activity. It will take minimum 20 minutes, but please do, because after doing this location and labeling of countries in outline political map of the world, definitely it will be easy for you to locate the countries in the board examination when it is asked. Let us move to the question number 3. Point out one feature in a practice of federalism in India that is similar to, and one feature that is different from that of Belgium. What is question expecting from you? We have federalism in these 2 countries, the country India as well as Belgium. We have to find out one similarity between India and Belgium and one difference between India and Belgium. So this is what you are expected to do. similarity and difference in the Federation of Belgium as well as India? Answer, please write down the answer. What is the similarity or the similar features? Like Belgian federalism, Indian federalism also gives constitutional power to the regional government. What is the same in India and Belgium? That in India as well as in Belgium, state governments gets power from the constitution. That's why they are called as constitutional powers to the regional or state government. This is same in both the countries, that is India as well as in Belgium. What is the difference? What is the different feature in India and Belgium? Unlike in Belgian federalism, in Indian federalism, regional and local governments are dependent on central government for finance and other matters of national importance. In Belgium, we studied that the regional governments are not dependent on state government. They are independent to operate. Whereas in India, the state government and the local self-government, we studied in the Indian federalism chapter, Indian federalism topic, that in India, the finance to the state and the local government should be given by the state government. Not complete, but a good share. That is what today we are seeing, SGST, State Goods and Services Tax. So what is the difference between Belgium and India? In Belgium, regional government are autonomous or independent, whereas in India, regional governments are under the control of central government for financial assistance. Hope you have completed question number 3. Let us move to the question number 4. This is, what is the main difference between federal form of government and unitary one? Explain with an example. The question expecting from you that what is the difference between federal and unitary. Before displaying answer, in a brief word I'll explain you. If in a country there exist two or more levels of government, that is called federal form of government. If in a country a single central government controls the entire country with subordinate local self-governments, that is called unitary form of government. America is an example for federal, China is an example for unitary form, because China is a communist form of government, it's not democratic, but still China is a unitary form of government. In an example where central government enjoys maximum or ultimate power and compared to state or regional government. Let us check the answer. Federal form of government. In a federal system, we can find two levels of government, one at the center and other at the state level. So, two levels of government. Both the government enjoy separate jurisdictions. Means, in a federal form of government, constitution gives separate power for the power to the state government as well as to the central government. That is called separate jurisdiction. For example, in India, we have state list and union list separately. Functions. What is the function of a federal form of government? In a federal form of government, state government is not answerable to the central government. The central government cannot impose its will on state government. This is in the case of pure federal, that is example of America, where state governments are independent from the control of central government. In few federal form of government, there is dual citizenship, one for the country and another one for the state. Dual citizenship, for example, a person belongs to Washington, California, he is considered as citizen of Washington as well as he is a citizen of United States of America. So he enjoys dual citizenship. In India, this feature is not there because we are not citizens of Karnataka as well as in India. We are the citizens of the country India. So in India, we have single citizenship, but in some federal form of government, we can find existence of dual citizenship. That is what the point 4 is given, that above feature is not exist in India. What is the feature? That is dual citizenship. In India, there is no existence of dual citizenship. We have single citizenship. Example for federation: Belgium, Canada, United States of America, Australia, many more countries which you have seen in the world political map. Please go through the map once again and try to locate and write the answer for the question. The second part of the question that expects you to explain about what? About unitary form of government. What is unitary form of government? In a unitary form of government or in a unitary system, we can find there is only one level of government. Some units, the spelling mistake is there, please rectify it. Some units are subordinate to the central government. There's a spelling mistake there, that is, it should be some. Some units are subordinate to the central government. Okay, what is the function of a unitary form of government? In a unitary form of government, the regional or local governments are under the control of central government, which I explained to you. In a unitary form of government, single as well as powerful central government exist, and the powerful central government controls the local units. There may or may not existence of state government. I repeat, there may or may not existence of state government, but if there is state government or central local government, they are definitely under the control of central government. Correct. Central government can pass the law to regulate the local governments. This is a feature of the unitary form of government. Central government can pass law to regulate the local self governments. Most of the unitary countries, rather all unitary countries, follow the system of single citizenship. In this system, only single citizenship is practiced. There is no dual citizenship. There is no separate citizenship for the country and the state. It is the single citizenship. Example for unitary model: China and France. Hope you have completed. Let us move to the question number 5. State any two difference between local government before and after constitutional amendment of 1992. I explained you that the implementation of Panchayat Raj Bill, the constitutional amendment of Panchayat Raj Bill, the implementation of Balwant Rai Mehta Committee introduced a landmark change in the Indian administrative system. Before 1992, what was the condition of local self-government? And after 1992, what is the condition of local self-government? That is the question expects from you. This is a very important topic. Generally, this question is repeated in the many, if you go through the old Cbse, old question papers, you can find this question repeated several times. Okay, I hope you wrote the question. Let us check the answer. Answer: before 1992, it was mandatory to hold regular elections for the local government bodies. So prior to 1992, it was not compulsory that conducting local self government elections once in 5 years was not mandatory, not compulsory. Means whenever the state government, central government feels they have money, or state government feel they have money, then only they used to conduct elections. Otherwise, they used to neglect the system of conducting election. Prior to 1992, there was no provision that the reservation of seats in local self-government for women in local self-government. That is, presently we have 1/3. So this kind of reservation was not there prior to 1992. This was the two conditions of local self-government before 1992. Let us see what is the condition at present or after 1992. After 1992, local governments. Now it's constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to the local government. Now it is very compulsory that once in 5 years, local self-government or the election for the municipality or the panchayat Taluk Panchayat, Jilla Parishad. It is compulsory that regular elections should be conducted for local self-governments. That is completion of term, that is 5 years. Now it is compulsory that in all these local self-governments, at least 1/3 of all the positions reserved for women in local self-government. So it is compulsory that 1/3 of total seats are reserved for women in the local self-government. So these are the certain additions or changes which introduced after 73rd amendment of Indian Constitution, that is the amendment of local self bodies or introduction of Panchayat Raj Bill. Introduction of Panchayat Raj Bill, that is Balwant Rai Mehta Committee, that is introduction of Panchayat Raj Bill. So we completed 5 questions. Draw the map, outline map of India, draw outline map of the world, political map, and complete all the question and answers which is completed till now. And leftover question we will continue in tomorrow. Take care. Bye.